The next organization that we will be looking at is similar to distributed shared memory, except that we are no longer sharing memory, so it's called distributed memory. No sharing of memory means that only one core can access a memory slice, and the others cannot. So what we now have is cores that have their own caches, and each of them has its own memory that can only be locally accessed here. So really, each of the core has pretty much what looks like a complete single-core computer system and a network interface card that connects it to a network. But now, when a core has a cache miss, that cache miss goes directly to this memory. And if the core wants to access something that is in another core's memory, it cannot simply issue an access that misses in the cache and goes there. Now what it needs to do is actually create a network message using some sort of a send primitive in the operating system to actually send a request. The program here needs to receive that, see what is being requested, respond to it, and so on. So now communication is explicit. It's no longer sufficient to simply put the data in memory and then another core just reads it from there. You have to actually send the data explicitly to another core if we want to communicate. So that means that you write programs differently from this. Symmetric shared memory and distributed shared memory pass data around using shared memory, meaning reads and writes to memory are used to exchange data. Now we are using what is called message passing for communication. So now you're pretty much writing a program as if these were independent machines that communicate over a network. If you have a distributed memory supercomputer, for example, it's just that this network and these network cards are a lot faster than your normal Ethernet connection. This type of a system is also called a multi-computer because really each of these is like a complete computer. It has the processor, the cache, the memory, some I/O, and the processor only directly accesses the local memory. So it looks like a complete uniprocessor system. These are also called cluster computers because really you put a bunch of normal computers together into a tightly networked cluster and you get something like a distributed memory system. These types of computers tend to scale to a large number of processors. The reason is not that they're fundamentally better at communicating than shared memory systems. The reason is mainly that the programmer is forced to explicitly think about communication because you use a different type of primitive to communicate than you use to access your local memory. So the programmer is aware of communication going on, and then naturally they will tend to minimize communication and, if at all possible, access the local memory. So this approach works better primarily because it forces the programmer to figure out things that otherwise it might not notice, because it forces the programmer to figure out how to communicate efficiently, whereas in shared memory, the programmer may not even realize that some of the accesses are not local and thus are slow and causing a lot of communication to happen.